welcome to laptop. This is the second video in the series of equipment qualification.
Now coming to the OQ or the operational qualification. After successful IQ, that is installation qualification, the instrument is ready for operational qualification. OQ is the documented collection of activities necessary to demonstrate that an instrument will function according to its qualification in the selected environment. This documentation includes secure data storage, backup, archiving, and functional test. The vendor or user must perform this qualification in the user's environment. OQ, which is to the operational qualification carried out by the manufacturer or supplier at the installation or service interval to verify the performance criteria presented by the manufacturer to confirm the instrument satisfies its agreed matrices and is valid in the working environment by verification against traceable references. Now we will see how to perform OQ or what are the things that should be included in the OQ. So we will see what is the exact protocol how we should perform the operational qualification. The objective should be to determine the system or the equipment operates according to the specification and to record all the relevant information and data to demonstrate that the system or equipment functions as expected. The scope is extended to perform after installation or modification or relocation and after the installation qualification has been completed. The responsibility lies with the person responsible for operating the system or equipment and who will perform the qualification and record the information. The supervisors will supervise the study with the completion of the records, write the deviation report and the operational qualification report. Quality assurance team will review and approve the OQ protocol and report. Now coming to step-by-step procedure, critical operating parameters should be identified for the equipment, systems, utilities and equipment should operate correctly and their operations should be verified in accordance with OQ protocol. Test and record calibration data for calibrating apparatus and instrument. Test and record operative conditions of control points and alarms. Test and record outputs. List of calibration requirements for the system under test and records of the calibration of the system. Studies on critical variables should include conditions encompassing normal, upper and lower operating limits and circumstances. This includes worst case condition. OQ should include verifications of all the operations of all systems, elements, parts, services, controls, gauges and other components. It can include, for example, the inspection of the display units, signals, temperature control and fluctuations, pressure and pressure controls, other humidity measurements or control system, if any rotating devices or fans or motors are there, temperature distribution systems. So these are the some of the examples of the operations that an instrument is performing verified and needs to be the operational qualification. Measure and record the results of specific challenge to the system in normal and worst case situation where appropriate. Record any deviations to the procedure performed. Any discrepancies or deviations should be recorded and investigated. The results for the verification of operation should be documented in the OQ report to indicate the satisfactory performance. SOPs for the operation should be finalized during the operational qualification protocol and approved during this phase of qualification. This is called document check in the operational qualification. Training of the operators for the systems, utilities, equipment should be provided and training records to be maintained, which is a part of operational qualification. Systems, utilities and equipment as appropriate should be released for PQ or routine use after completion of OQ. All calibrations, cleaning, maintenance, training and related tests and results should be verified to be acceptable. Assure the system is functioning to acceptable limits by testing relevant instruments, specifications, parameters and ranges as determined by instrument protocol. Collect the screenshots for whatever operating procedures or whatever operational testings are being done and the results either should be printed or should be screenshot. Now coming to the OQ report, these screenshots and printouts serves as a raw data for the operational qualification and to be included in OQ report. After completion of the operational qualification OQ, the results are summarized, evaluated and compiled in an OQ report. Prepare an operational qualification report. This should include data study initiated, data completed, observations made, problems encountered, completeness of information collected, summary of deviation reports, results of controls and alarm tests, sample data if appropriate, location of original data, other information relevant to the studies and conclusions on the validity of the equipment, systems, operations. Prepare a deviation report including the justification of acceptance and impact on the operation. All deviations as well as measures taken to eliminate these should be documented. The outcome of the OQ should be recorded in the conclusion of the report before PQ or performance qualification is started. Submit the OQ for review and approval. After successful completed operational qualification, this is released by the signature of the persons responsible for qualification team, countersigned by the users of the equipment and accepted by the quality assurance team, thus completing the process or release the equipment for use or performance qualification. So with this, we have completed the protocol for operational qualifications and the procedure to perform the operational qualifications of equipment in laboratory. In the next video, we will see about performance qualification. So stay tuned with Lab Talk and do share your feedback and queries at the mentioned email IDs and phone number. Thank you.